Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain the difference between single influence and double influence. So I will be explaining the differences with the help of diagram, as well as I will be writing the C structure so that you can understand the difference like how they actually works. So first I am going to draw the diagram for single influence mapping. So whenever we create single influence, so first we need to create a start pointer which contains null. Right now, if I want to add a load into this linkage, so this is node number one. It is internally divided into two parts. So first one is information, and second is a pointer that we hold address of next node. And let's say its address is 1001, so it will be stored into start, right? So this way it is connected. Now if we have one more node, so it is also having two parts, info and next. And let's say its base address is 2001, then we have node number T, and its base address is 3001. So 1001 is stored here, value is 10, that is info, and node 1, next pointer will be storing base address of node 2. So it will be having value as 2001. Now let's say its information is 20, and its next part will be having address of base address of next node. Now this is third node, its information is 30. And it is not having any further nodes, so its next will be having null. So this is the representation of single influence. And if I create structure, C structure for this, so I need to write struct linked list, then in info. So this is for this first member, and then struct linked list pointer next. So this is the structure that you need to declare in C language if you are going to write a program for this. And this structure is basically as self referential structure. Why so? Because here you can see structure is using its own data type to create a pointer here. Why so? Because this pointer is holding address of this node, and this node is type of struct linked, right? So whenever we declare a pointer, so pointer holds address of a memory location. So we need to declare pointer of that type similar to the type of memory location. So this memory location is having type as struct linked. So we need to declare this pointer as of same type. So here you can see this is a pointer and its data type is struct linked. So this way, single influence memory maps in front of you, which is internally connected with different addresses. And this way we create a structure if we want to implement its program in C language. Now I am coming to double influence. So in case of single influence, what we can do, we can traverse from left to right only. If we are on 30, so we cannot backtrack to 20 or 10. But that can happen with double influence. So now understand the double influence memory map. Initially it is null. Now I can do store first value. So I need to create a node. So now the node which you will be creating will be having three parts. This first part will, sorry, second part will be info. It is pointed to previous, it is pointed to forward. And let's say this is node number one, its base address is 1001, so it will be stored here. And right now, if you want to store any information, so that can go here, or you can specify any order. You want to store information first, then previous pointer and then forward pointer, then you can use that as well. That totally depends on the statement sequence that you are going to write in your structure. Now let me declare one more node. So this is node 2. Let's say its base address is 2001. This is node 3. Its base address is 3001. And each node will be divided into 3 parts. Now let's assign the values. So let's assign value first 10, 20, and 30. Right? This is previous, so this node is the first node, so its previous is not possible, so it will be null. This node is the last node, so its forward is not possible, so it will be null. Now, this is first node, so its base address is available at the start. Its forward will be having base address of node 2, so 2001 will store here. This is node 2, and its previous node is node 1, so node 1 base address will be available into previous pointer of this node 2. So it will be having 1001. Then node 2 forward is node 3. So its base address 3001 will be stored here. And node 3 previous is node 2. So node 2's base address is 2001 that will be stored here. So now if you are on node 1, so you can move to node 2 and node 3. If you are on node 3, so node 3 previous pointer is having its previous node address. So you can move from node 3 to node 2, node 2 to node 1. So you can move in both the directions, either left to right or right to left. That's why it is known as double nodes. Right? And now they are connected bidirectionally and they are connected bidirectionally. So this way you can create double nodes. Now if you want to create its structure, so what you can do, you can write in info, or if you want to allocate memory in this way only, like first previous then info and then forward pointer. So this is in info. Before that you can write struct linked list pointer previous, and here you can write pointer forward. So this way three blocks will be created wherever you will be allocating any variable or memory pointer. So this way you can create a structure for self-referential structure for double linked list. So I hope now you understood the difference between single linked list and double linked list. And also you can consider it as advantage of double linked list, like we can move in both the directions. Now we have one more thing, that is two-way linked list. Two-way linked list, so we can have one more pointer. So this is start pointer. We can have one more pointer that will be end pointer, and it will be having address of last node. So what happens now if you want to print the reverse of linked list? So you can use this last node address with the help of this end pointer, and you can backtrack the whole linked list. So this type of linked list is basically known as two-way linked list, which has two pointers, one for start and one for end. So if you have a particular address, let's say if you have a start pointer and you have address 1001, so you can move from left to right. If you have another pointer and that is having address at 3001, so with this help, with the help of this pointer, you can move from right to left. Right? So you can move in both the directions. So these kind of linked are known as two-way linked list. So through this minor change, you can convert your double linked list into two-way linked list. So these are more or less similar because we just need to create one more pointer so that we can implement two-way linked list kind of concept. So whenever you will be implementing your programs based on double linked list, so then you can have end pointer as well, so that you will be having two addresses. One pointer is having address of first node, and another pointer is having address of last node, so that you can efficiently manage your double linked list. Right? So this way, I hope you understood the difference between single and double linked list. And if you want to watch like how we can write algorithms for insertion and deletion in single linked list and double linked list, so you can go to description of this video. You will be having links of playlists related to data structure and algorithm. So follow that playlist and you will find all the videos related to data structures and algorithm on that playlist. So watch the watch the videos which are available there so that you can learn data structure and algorithm. Thank you for watching this video.